Hi, this is Carrie with Icekeeper One, and this is the parks trip on the house we're renting. When I turned the water on to the sprinkler zone, none of the heads popped up, and on closer inspection I noticed a leak in the last head. It looks like a car has run over the head and either broke the sprinkler head or the sprinkler line supplying the head. So what I'll do is turn the water off to this zone at the timer and dig up the area around the head to see what's going on. To me, it looks like when the car ran over the head, it pulled the funny pipe off the barb fitting going into the head. I could just cut back on the funny pipe a couple of inches and try the head again, but the head is positioned wrong. The head should be in the corner of the park strip, so what I'll do is chase the funny pipe to the fitting on the sprinkler pipe and replace the funny pipe with a new piece so I can position the head in the corner of the park strip. When I do sprinkler repairs, I like to use new parts. That way I don't have to worry about the old parts failing, requiring me to dig up the head again. With the funny pipe exposed, I'll take my knife and cut a slit in the funny pipe where it connects to the barb elbow. Then I'll remove the old piece of funny pipe, install a new half-inch barb elbow, and shove a new length of funny pipe onto the new elbow. Remember, with funny pipe you don't need clamps or glue. With one end of the funny pipe attached to the barb elbow on the sprinkler line, next I'll install a Rainbird 15 van nozzle and screen into the shaft of the sprinkler body. Van stands for variable arc nozzle. Then I'll thread a new barb elbow into the bottom of the sprinkler head. Once that's done, I'll position the head into the corner and measure where I need to cut the funny pipe. After I make the cut, I'll shove the end of the funny pipe onto the barb elbow. I'm now ready to bury the head. While holding the head in the corner at the correct elevation with one hand, I'll pull dirt into the hole with the other hand, compacting the dirt around the sprinkler head. Once the head is stable, I'll finish backfilling the hole, continuing to pack dirt around the sprinkler. Okay, the head is in place, and next I'll turn on the water to the sprinkler zone and adjust the pattern and radius of the head. First, I'll line up the 0 degrees on the nozzle with the left edge of the park strip. Then I'll twist the collar underneath the nozzle to set the spray pattern or arc of the head. Once the pattern or arc is set, I'll take the flat blade screwdriver and twist clockwise on the radius screw to reduce the distance the head is watering, so that it doesn't spray out into the street. To increase the distance the spray head will water, I'll twist counterclockwise on the screw. With the nozzle adjusted, I'm done with the repair. If you like this video, share it and click the thumbs up. And if you'd like to see more of my videos, please visit my YouTube channel, Icekeeper1.